for one, am grateful, Mrs. Bush, that they are finally bringing civilization to the savage land.
I could not agree with you more, my dear. My daddy settled this land, and I know he'll be looking down on us, pleased with how we help the natives.
Yes, they've lost their land, but they've gained access to heaven.
But Father, do you mean unless an innocent receives communion, they're destined to go to hell? It hardly seems fair.
What I mean to say, Jenny, is that there is a great deal of difference between an innocent and a savage.
I never thought of it that way.
Yes, they live like animals, but they're happier now.
Not only do people now have motor cars, Father, but I heard that pretty soon we will be able to fly.
No, only angels can fly, Jenny.
No, apparently people can fly. Didn't you hear? Out in Kansas, a man even got a car to fly.
I hardly think so, Jenny.
Apparently, Mr. Johns wants to run for governor, which is why he's so concerned with cleaning up the state.
Nate Johns.
Yes.
His family is nothing but hillbilly trash that came here after the war. I don't want to be judgmental, but this state should not be ruled by such a disgusting family. A family without class.
Apparently. The Johns family have made a lot of money, and he has a lot of friends in politics.
Mrs. Bush, money isn't everything. There are many things that money cannot buy.
It seems that money can buy voters, though.
What you must remember, my dear, is that we have been brought here to spread the word. And the word and civilization, they are the same thing. They are the gifts. It is the opportunity we have, the chance to live among people who are decent and who do not kill each other, and who let you worship in peace.
It's so confusing, Father. Sometimes I find it impossible to make the distinction between a loving act and a hateful one. I mean, they often seem to be the same thing.
Yes, Jenny, it is confusing. But you only have to ask me if you need help.
Indeed.
Well, here we are, Mrs. Bush. Armadillo.
Must be John Marston.
Sometimes.
I'm Jake. Your friends from Blackwater hired me to guide you.
Hey, my friends. I'm pleased to meet you, Jake.
I got the horses saddled up and ready out front. You ain't gonna find sturdier horses than these in all of New Ulster. If you say so. Take it slow on the way out of town. No need to kick up a lot of dust. Whoa!
right?
Ain't taking nobody up to the fort in a long time. Strange place for a decent fella to want to visit, if you don't mind me saying.
Who said I was a decent fella?
It's been abandoned for years now. Folks say it was built during the Mexican War. What kinds of soldiers around back then?
Why'd they leave?
Well, I ain't entirely sure. I heard they had to go up north to fight Indians, or maybe they got tired of being soldiers and went looking for gold. You know how things is. So what are you
doing? You're an old friend.
Well, like I says, you ain't gonna find many folk around those parts these days. Those you do find are about as sociable as an ulcerated back tooth. I mean, I ain't one to judge a man by the company he keeps, but...
Well, he ain't been friends for a long time.
Are you planning on spending any time in Armadillo, Mr. Marston?
I doubt it. I ain't planning on staying very long.
Well, if you're fixing for some female company, you can do a lot worse than Armadillo. Fine as cream gravy they are. Not like Thieves Landing. Dang, those girls ain't even fit for a drinking man to hole up with.
I'm a married man, I'm afraid.
Ain't we all? The marshal who hired me, Lee Johnson. Do you know him?
I think I heard his name.
Says he got a telegram from some Blackwater big bugs asking for a guide. I guess it's none of my business.
That's right.
You ain't very talkative, are you?
Nope.
I'm just chewing the dog, mister. It's how I am. I don't mean nothing by it.
Trust me. There's things you're better off not knowing.
I tell you, Mr. Marston, those coyotes eat better than I do. Almost there, Mr. Marston. Just over this hill.
Whoa there.
Giddy up.
Easy.
Listen, mister. This here is what's left of Fort Mercer. Some gang rode in and took the place over.
So I understand. Here!
Come for you! Bill Williamson! Come out here right now!
Go away now, John! Don't make me kill you.
Nobody needs to kill anyone, Bill!
You must think I was born yesterday. You always did think I was an idiot.
That ain't fair, Bill. You were as my brother. I've come to try to save you.
Oh. Do I look like I need saving?
Bill, please. They want to kill us all. I can help you.
Well, you never tried to save me before. You only seemed to save yourself.
Bill. I implore you, think about this.
You implore me? You implore me. You always were one for fancy words. Oh. Well, things are different now, John. Now I'm in charge! No more Dutch! And no more you. Implores. I implores you to go back and tell them to send someone just a little bit more impressive next time.
Well?
Oh. Poor John.
Well, you're alive.
So it would seem.
So, how do you feel?
I don't know the polite word for it.
I do. Stupid is the word we use around here. What were you doing?
I was doing something stupid.
Well, you'll be okay. Once you didn't die, the doctor said you'd be fine. He got the bullets out a couple days ago.
Good.
It cost us $15.
I'm sorry, madam. Should have left me there to die.
Did you want to die? I mean, was that it? Was that why you went straight out to Fort Mercer and picked a fight with the worst bandit in the county? To die,
Mr. Marston. John Marston.
Bonnie McFarlane. Miss Bonnie McFarlane.
Well, you may be right, Miss McFarlane. I don't know.
Huh. So what were you doing?
Trying to give Mr. Williamson a chance. For old time's sake.
You know Bill Williamson?
Knew him. Long time ago.
Well, what was he like?
Dumb.
Just like you.
Thank you, miss. Seen my hat?
I have. And, what will you do now?
Now I'm gonna take my time and go after him the less kind way.
Well, that sounds very fun, Mr. Marston. Quite heroic, just like in those penny dreadfuls my brother used to read. Meanwhile, if you'll excuse me, I've got a ranch to run. Of course, if you're feeling better, why not take a ride with me later and help me patrol the perimeter? You can earn back some of that money we wasted on doctor's bills.
Of course. And thank you for saving my life, I mean.
Next time, Mr. Marston, I strongly recommend you don't try to lose it quite so earnestly.
I'll bear that in mind.
In the land of the living, I see.
Figured it's about time I started paying back that $15.
I sure can use an extra pair of hands around here. Let's see if we can get you back in the saddle. How am I gonna show you the ranch if you keep racing off ahead? Do you even know where you're going? There's the foreman's office. It's also where we lock up good-for-nothing outlaws, such as yourself.
I'm happy enough with my current quarters right now, Miss McFarlane.
I picked out a fine horse for you. Yeah! Come on, then. I'll show you around the property.
right as the general store. You won't find Parisian high fashion, but it's good for the essentials.
Very convenient. I don't think I've ever seen a ranch with its own store before.
And here's the corral. This one's for the horses. What do you think?
I'm no expert, but it certainly looks like a fine corral.
I suspect you've stolen more horses than you've broken.
Now, where'd you get such an idea?
First impressions are hard to erase. That's the train station. Things sure have changed since the line finally got finished, bringing in all sorts of new folk like yourself.
Is that such a bad thing?
Change is only good when it makes things better.
Complaints from me, Miss McFarlane. Come on!
Come on, this is the only chance you're gonna get to rest.
How about a cold drink, Mr. Marston?
Thank you, ma'am. Getting shot, then riding a horse seems to take it out of you. I could use a rest.
Sure. Come on in. I'll show you the house, and then you can sit for a while.
Thank you.
Mr. Marston.
Miss McFarlane.
Remember me telling you about the trouble we've been having with rustlers and other undesirables?
I do.
Will you help me keep watch on the property line this evening? I want to see just who is trespassing on our land.
This is a fine weapon.
Come, let's head out. The country is really beautiful at around this time.
Come on, then. Let's mount up and take a look around. Suspicious. Thank you, Mr. Marston. I feel a lot happier someone's along with me.
I feel a lot happier now I got a rifle.
Well, with your trigger itch and my feminine intuition, we should make quite a team.
Let's go.
Again. Get down and give me a hand, will you? You're better at shooting rabbits than outlaws, I see. Get your rifle out. It's about time these little thieves met their maker.
Whoa there.
You're a good shot, Mr. Marston. Them rabbits didn't stand a chance.
Living off the land like this. Maybe you should.
Look out! Coyote! Get him before they get the animal! Come on, boy!
Yeah!
Whoa! But shoot! coyotes. Just a shame we had to lose any of the chickens. Come on, I'll show you the way to your room.
Slow down!
You know, you can actually handle a rifle.
It's something I've had a little experience in.
Maybe Bill Williamson did get lucky after all.
Luck didn't really come into it, miss.
You're a useful man to have around the ranch, that's for sure. But don't think I've forgotten what brought you here. We'll do whatever we can to help you.
I sure appreciate that, Miss McFarland. Go!
Here we are. Thank you for your help, Mr. Marston. Makes me...
Follow Charlie. He's a good one to sniff out trouble. Stay close to Charlie.
What have you got?
I'm gonna have man for breakfast.
Just calm down and think for a second, you crazy fool.
Don't let me catch you here again! Apologies, mister.
Let's go!
Easy now! On the count of three. 3, 2, 1, go! I trust you're not gonna be a gentleman about this!
You don't know me at all, Miss McFarland! Watch and learn, miss! Gentlemen!
That was
locked
fun.
Lock me up like that? That sucks.
Sure.
You know, you should go pay the marshal a visit in Armadillo sometime. I'm sure he could help you deal with that nice Mr. Williamson.
Yeah, I might just do that, Miss McFarland.
You do whatever you think's best, Mr. Marston. Ah, Mr. Marston, how are you?
Good.
Hop on up, Mr. Marston. You're looking much better, considering you were almost buzzard food a couple days ago.
I have you to thank for that, miss.
So do tell me, have you needlessly risked your life since we last spoke?
No, miss, I have not.
Well, that's a relief. Perhaps there's hope for you yet.
I wouldn't bet on it.
Oh, there's always hope, Mr. Marston. You can't be a rancher in this kind of country if you don't believe that.
An admirable attitude, miss.
I suppose so. I can't think of any other way to stay sane, to be frank. What about you? Have you ever given up hope altogether?
Hope hasn't really entered into it. It's not really something I think about.
A peculiar outlook. I can't really say I understand you.
I can't always say I do either.
Oh, don't be so deliberately enigmatic.
I'm not, miss.
Yes, you are. You are being deliberately obscure as a substitute for having a personality.
I just know there are two theories to arguing with women. And neither one works.
I'm not even going to dignify that gibberish with a response. I think it's kind of funny I found
have a strange sense of humor.
Well, you must admit, it's an unusual start to a friendship.
I didn't realize we were friends, Miss McFarland.
Oh, please. Now who's being funny? Listen, I know that business with Williamson is your business, but I don't know. You've been good to us, and I don't think you're a bad man. A little stupid, perhaps, but not rotten. I just worry about you gallivanting around these parts like you're some kind of deranged bounty hunter. Like Paul always says, don't go waking snakes.
I appreciate your concern for us lesser mortals, Miss McFarland. I really do. And if there was any other way out, I'd take it. I can assure you of that.
You never did tell me where you live.
I have a small holding up in Great Plains.
A farmer? Yeah, and I'm the Queen of England. And at what point during your day of hunting down outlaws do you find time to raise chickens?
Only been at it 3 years or so. I guess I'm kind of new to it.
You're telling me? So who's looking after this farm of yours right now?
Uncle. Well, he's not my uncle, as far as I know. Just an old dog who's as lazy as a lizard on a hot day.
So this is Armadillo. Manhattan it is not, but it does okay for us. Most important thing for you right now is getting yourself into Dr. Johnson's office to purchase some medicine. The first one's on me.
Thank you, miss. I'll pay you back.
I'm sure you shall. The doc's a good fellow. He saved your life, so be polite to him. Meet me in front of the general store when you're done.
Excellent to see you today.
The marshal ain't no man.
How are you, friend?
I got stock of them electric belts if you need to lose weight.
Much obliged.
Be well.
Come by any time.
Marshal, best step up post haste. His big mouth got him killed.
Well, thanks for driving me. It was nice to be able to enjoy the view for once. And a little company never hurts now and again.
You're more than welcome, miss. Least I can do. Thank you for the medicine.
Why don't you have a look around Armadillo? You can always take a stagecoach back to the ranch later.
I might just do that. Travel safely, miss.
Try not to get yourself shot. I won't be around to save you this time.
I'm telling you, that Nate Johns is just a front for Southwestern Raiders.
Like first. Don't you move,
now, you
friend.
You don't want to put that gun away.
Okay. well. Come on!
Come on,
easy up now.
Here, please take this.
It's a pleasure to help. This'll fetch a good price. Lie still. This is nasty. Come on, let's get this over with. Go!
How good are you with iron? I bet you can't beat Ira Shelton in shooting. I'll bet you money.
Sure. I always enjoy putting a man in the way. You'll get there eventually.
Ain't that? All right, here's your win.
Let's go! Load up now.
It's an honor to help.
Get
him. Tough one, ain't you? Let's go.
killing. For some reason, they left me alone.
What's going on?
Well, protecting yourself?
Hello, sir.
Well, I'm always after items of quality.
How do you do? Hello.
A fine transaction. The marshal may as well hand Armadillo over to them thugs for all he does to stop them. Nice doing business. I'm thinking that were mutually beneficial. I hear that marshal pisses in a squat, if you catch my meaning. Now stay safe.
Let's begin.